going to go through the chord shapes first. We need just four chords. The first one is C add 9. Okay, so it's pretty much like a C chord. You've got this extra note added in here, this D note. Okay, so that's that one. Second chord, a G. Okay, I'll put the tab underneath. I'm not going to bother to play the B on that one. Third chord is a D sus 4, and the fourth chord, E minor. So we've got two beats on each chord. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So make sure you can get that first, and then let's try a bit of percussion in, and I'll just take a bit of a detour, and we'll have a look at doing a good rhythm pattern for the verse, and that would be something like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now let's beef it up a bit. So say we're going to go into the chorus. If you listen to the record, there's a really strong drum beat on the 2 and the 4, which I'm trying to do with this slap on the guitar. Okay, now, so taking a bit of a detour, let's go back and have a look at the introduction and the finger picking part to that. So here's the introduction. We'll look at the first bar. The chords are two beats on the C, and it goes to the G. Okay, so let's go through that in detail. Do one down straw on the C, hit the guitar on the second beat, and then we've got to put this like sort of little picking bit in. So let me slow that down. We're going to start on the B string, and we're holding the G chord down now. So that's the chord we've got there. We're going to hold the G chord down, and I'll just shout out the string. So we start off with the B string, then the E string, then the D string, then the G string, then the B, and again G, and then D. Okay. So you're probably going to have to practice this for a while. Together. And again. Now, just probably worth noting that the first note comes in before the beat. Two, three. So the third beat falls when you hit G, the bass G. Okay, now we move to the second bar, strum the D sus 4 chord. At this time, we're going, instead of doing one, we're going to do two hits. So that's one, two, and. Go to the E minor chord, and we do the same picking pattern that we did before in the other bar on the E minor chord. So again, you've got this open B string coming in just a bit before the beat. It's quite tricky this, so. Got it to there. So it's worth just taking a bit of time out and just practicing this sort of fast picking bit. That's on the G again. Now you'll notice on the G that you don't actually need all the fingers down on that. You're not using the top string. And again on the E minor, you're only using the same strings. quinter note with this riff is you've got to do a bit of damping with the chords. So by the time you tap the guitar, you should have damped the chord, your initial C chord, and then your initial D sus4 chord. Damp. So it's like that. Release. And then to the E minor. So hopefully that gives you enough stuff to put a good back into the whole of the song together, really. Alright. Okay. Thanks a lot.